We're live in the city of Winnipeg for a CPL Sunday doubleheader that begins with a very hungry Valour side trying to make it two wins from two and keep their slim playoff hopes alive against a side that has not made this flight to Manitoba and won in this stadium since 2019. That is, of course, Forge FC. Matching a season high in goals in that 3-1 win against the York United, Phil Dos Santos selects to not make a single change. Do not touch something that is working so well, or at least worked so well. Bobby Spyriotis has gone on and made three changes to his team today. The return from international duty for Garvin Mishay-Matusla. He starts at left back as a center back duo of Ashinyoti Janssen and James beside him. Rezard Rama, of course, at right back. Kyle Becker and Abubakar Sissoko in midfield. Kadeem Kane is going to start with them there. Becker goes into the box this time, and Alex Ashinyoti Janssen has his effort.
Pierre and Scheller steps in well.
Back heel from Gutierrez, Tepperian into the box. It's a free header for Kian Williams with a gaping goal mouth and puts it about 3 yards to the left of the far post, leading the line for Forge. Amandrikar James.
They're all fighting.
Yes, it's race for the ball, but he gets his timing. He does, and it's a wide open net for Abubakar Sissoko, who's absolutely not going to make a mistake from there. One of those dangerous balls, and Yesley had to make a decision. Unfortunately, the big man got his timing wrong, and Forge leads this match very early days. It's a darting run this time from Dibran, brings the center backs with him. That creates an opening, and what a shot that is. Pitched up to himself and struck it well. Second chance, and he buries it! An instantaneous response to Valour. And Ryan is going to be heating a big sigh of relief. Exactly what you want to see as a Valour supporter. They go right back to work. Henry denies the first, but Kian Williams.
Well, you see him in a composite defensive midfield role now. And I think by doing that, it's freed up Tiberian and Sanchez and Gutierrez. And
very clever, nice and fluid for Valour as they found an opening. Pablo Sanchez on the ball, fakes the cross and gets his defenders on skates. Now Sanchez goes to Henry, forces another really good acrobatic stop from Tristan. And it has to have that horizontal clearance as that was awfully close to a corner kick. Possession passes back towards the middle to Vernier, and the teenager creates some separation around Sanchez. He plays a great ball for Taron Campbell on his left side. Yes, he makes the stop. Really good job keeping the ball through. Nearly 9 minutes here for Rama. Again goes studs up, and again he is lucky to come with the ball. Here's Batty Bonga. Polisi defending. Batty Bonga goes for Cole, does not miss, dipping that under the crossbar by very much. Polisi in the pocket. He's leading to Brandon, and he gets a piece of it, and he knocks it down to Henry, and he's taking the lead from Valour. Number 22 makes it 2, and lead to MDB. Spinning on his side, as he believes the keeper on possession is kick free. He's going to stand as the second goal of the match, and the security guard cuts some off for the goal score. Just very clever. Good feed for Hijabakur. They're in between hands. Rama's in. Rezard Rama come back and Casillas. It's an alley-oop for Forge. That's what they've been waiting for. And the goals have come often from number 17 when they found them. Rubens Casillas makes a near immediate impact on this game. It was just absolutely gorgeous from Forge. 1-2-3 in the back of the net. We're level again. Danny Banga. Casillas going into the box. Becker short option. He goes forward as well. Becker first time. Needed a place and obviously tucked it in. Have a lot of room. Here's your, but we digress.
I'd be surprised if anybody is not playing in this one.
Okay, Kyle Lepp is going to make sure he's his meter away from the wall. I'm going to have that 7-hour debate again. With Alessandro Hojabrapour, and that is full time.